Okay, poop is pretty gross. We flush it, we mask it, we avoid talking about it at all costs. But what if poop could save your life? I mean, like, literally, poop could save your life. This is On the Fringe, a show about weird ideas that just might change the world.
You know, poop is a funny subject for many, and we kind of welcome that. We take our work very seriously, but take ourselves lightly.
This is Majdi Osman, the Clinical Program Director at Open Biome. It's a stool bank. Like a blood bank, but for poop.
We're a non-profit stool bank, so we provide fecal material for fecal transplants.
Yes, you heard that right. Fecal transplants.
Yes, it is literally exactly what it sounds like.
This is Carolyn Edelstein, the executive director of Open Biome. But her bit comes a little later, so let's go back to Majdi. No, not the dog again.
Basically, you're taking poop from a healthy individual and transplanting it into an individual who has the disease that you're trying to treat.
You might be asking, why in God's name would anyone want to do that? This procedure is often a last resort for people with Clostridium difficile, or C. diff infections.
C. diff is a really nasty gut bug, and it gives you pretty aggressive diarrhea.
This little bastard is C. diff. It's a bacteria that's extremely common in the environment at large, as well as in many people's digestive systems. Normally, it's no big deal. But if it gets out of control in your tummy, it can cause an infection. And that infection affects roughly 500,000 people every year, and about 29,000 of them will die.
The sense of desperation that comes with someone with C. diff is unmeasurable.
This is Jessica Benoit. She contracted a C. diff infection 2 months before her wedding, and antibiotics weren't working.
It just got worse. I was septic. My joints were swollen. I had a fever. I couldn't move. I was bleeding.
Jessica was dying.
And I'm so sorry. I was finally at the point, I think, towards the end of the fight of this may actually happen. I was about ready to give up.
That's when her doctor mentioned the idea of a fecal transplant, or FMT. And when she asked him why he thought it was a good idea to tell a dying woman that he wanted to put someone else's poop into her body, he probably said it had something to do with her microbiome.
So where's this, what?
Your microbiome is the sum total of all the microbial life that lives on or in your body, both the good and the bad. In your gut, these bacteria help you process your food, maintain your metabolism, and otherwise stay alive. The health of your gut biome can be a critical factor in your health. And your poop is basically just a to-go version of your gut biome.
What we're really transplanting are the community of bacteria, and that eventually leads to a resolution of the person's symptoms and a rebalancing of the microbial community in the gut.
The poop from donors can't be sterilized because that would defeat the whole purpose. So donors are rigorously screened to make sure they're very healthy. Less than 3% of people make the cut. But if you happen to be one of these super healthy individuals, you could get paid $40 per donation.
I got a kick out of it. I giggled. I remember laughing. I was like, this is fantastic. Sure, like, let's give it a shot. These people are trusting in it. The science seems to be there. I read the studies and I was curious. My doctor, it was among the first times he had actually administered one. We got the transplant matter from Open Biome, and we go back, show everyone and their mother my rear, get it inputted, and then you go back to the room and you have to sit on your side, on your left side, and just kind of in the fetal position, letting it marinate, if you will.
After the procedure, Jessica went home and went to sleep, anxious to see if the procedure would work.
I was so tired of feeling sick that I started to go a little nuts. And that was just the icing on the cake. And you're like, I've really just put someone else's matter up in my colon. Man, I've really gotten to the point of just anything goes at this rate. But it worked. Honestly, the feeling was almost instantaneous. I was back at the office the next day. FMT is tremendous.
The most rewarding part of the work that we do is the fact that as a team, we show up every day, we do our jobs, and somebody gets better. It just so happens that that life-saving treatment is made out of poop.
There's still a lot we don't know about fecal transplants, but we do know it works. In 2013, the New England Journal of Medicine conducted a study on patients with C. diff that produced astounding results. Fecal transplants were 3 times more effective than traditional antibiotics.
It's pretty awesome.
Since that report, there's been a growing interest in the procedure. Open Biome was founded to make performing or researching FMT easier.
It's such a privilege to be kind of at the forefront of a field that is really kind of shaping medicine as we know it.
There's actually evidence to suggest that fecal transplants can help treat a huge number of conditions. Things as diverse as irritable bowel syndrome or Crohn's, but also things like MS or even alopecia. The gut microbiome simply plays a huge role in our overall health. The problem is that we still aren't quite sure what bacteria is being introduced.
Poop is a very complex mixture, and we're really not sure at the moment which component of poop is the one that leads to clinical resolution.
Researchers are hoping to begin tracking what changes before and after a transplant so they can identify exactly what microbes are changing. In the meantime, the FDA has given the green light for these procedures to continue, meaning thousands more will have their lives saved by someone's poop.